trees are gone as virgin forest. Breathtaking. Dense. Beautiful. The same rainforest that gave birth to the world's top quality cocoa. Timber. Food crops. And countless wild creatures. The same forest that keep our sparkling streams and rolling rivers packed with different species of fish that used to gladden many a cooking pot. The same rainforest that were the womb of the limitless precious metals and stones, including the yellow metal that inspired the name the Gold Coast. These rainforests are now infected with a raging and relentless disease that is quickly changing our God-given Garden of Eden. Into a barren wasteland. This very moment, our Ghana is under attack by shameless rapists. For quick money, they're eroding all her beauty, hacking away, digging away, washing away. Defacing, ravishing. And stealing her precious stones like a swarm of rapacious locusts. As they say, you can choose your sins, but you cannot choose the consequences. Our water bodies and the aquatic life that used to abound in them are slowly dying from physical and chemical pollution. If you think this is only a myth, imagine the copious use of the deadly chemical called mercury, which is applied by illegal miners in the extraction of gold dust. The fish you sometimes buy from the market may well be contaminated by this very dangerous chemical. an obvious threat to the local food chain to our public health systems. From the northern savanna ecological zones to our natural forest and game reserves, the devastation caused by illegal small-scale mining is of monumental proportions. Yet another crucial sector that illegal small-scale mining is crippling is the agricultural sector. Not only is our food chain in jeopardy, but large tracts of our farmlands have been converted into illegal mining enclaves. Whilst many of our able-bodied youth migrate away from food and cash crop farming ventures into the illegal and debilitating act of Galamsey.
Am I a natural resource to the brain? The name of money, a bear my team, the beans and cocoa, timber, bauxite, manganese, gold, and the crowd they were saying, yeah, you to say, farm, ah, if you know oil, yeah, but now, I did about a coin, this is me, by a hearing, so on, he said, on your menu, or the idea, and my end. One can see a mayor in a bassa bassa. A nipper or so a boy to send an ancestor. A dear back when I see nipper a baying in a chimney said, I did be a yay in a wee icy mohano. A big one home at one point I will not go away. Being in legal man, yeah, more coming, more can't want to. Offense, I say, the fidelity in a dear I tie ye. Ye cook where you craft for. Net timber will happen. There were foreign reserves, Marco, and Kunong. Since I'm no more can say reserves in Nina and I'm bad management in tea. Oh, my ever so I have some to papa my in tea. I must have reserves in Nina. I say, as Antiha, I will be a year to gold. And I will be a sebu, ye dear, do my dear, a fluent in Kronibania yen. And I dear, the other say. The Aban said, baby, yada, if I say you two scow.
But we also pay another price for illegal mining. More and more often these days, illegal mining results in death. Countless families have lost their able-bodied young men and women to this canker.
The human cost is high. This is what happened when one river burst through the barrier.
Kwasi anabi nwo so okwadwuma ene wo koy ti me nso me kwa so ni ti me ba no Kwasano wa chichiru le kuroba akuru. Sitemi ba na mtini se. Yesi mkofumia unkofumia untimi ni. Mbedu kwa mnu mbikache nisemi niyano. Miniyano na mena ebu ya guniso.
Communities have also been burdened with countless numbers of grieving widows and orphans.
We are at the site where the disaster which occurred in April 2013. The miner left the pit uncovered and he brought in excavator and bulldozer to cover the pit. Whilst working, the people of Ejakrum, Chichiwure and Amwafu rushed here and then start doing illegal mining. Unfortunately for them, the pit broke and then caved them. And out of those who were there, were able to retrieve or pick up 16 dead bodies. And then 6 were alive and rushed to the health center at Chichiwure.
First, now you're my brother. A friend of Kofi Amankwa. Na yeyi sad body nipa makoma 16 okay edi omunyina to.
For the residents of Galamsey communities, no place is safe. Children can no longer frolic and play about with careless abandon, lest the many abandoned pits swallow them alive.
This is my school, and this is the water. You know, if break time, we can pray. This girl, I'm saying, destroy our park. So they didn't get part to play football or playing games. So it destroyed our park.
I'm not there. They say one to make a thousand money in the park. They say if you answer, I'm quite likely to buy more. I'm so many bonds we have. The other thing answer we try and go here. Say I could have been better. So we want to go far at the end of the month. I'm not there. They're in prison so far. We are not many bonds we have. We are not announcement. They say I'm going to put in the hand.
Traditional authority is eroding and chaos is manifest everywhere. And as if looting our land were not enough, the perpetrators of illegal mining also poison the morals of the communities in which they ply their trade. Galamsey endemic communities are awash with social vices. Immorality. Prostitution. HIV. Armed gangsterism. Insecurity among community members, fear, intimidation, and poverty. The environmental and social blights of illegal mining pose a real threat to sustainable livelihoods. It is for this reason that the President of the Republic constituted an interministerial task force with a clear mandate to actively flush out the actors of this canker. In the short time since it was set up, the task force has seized much of the equipment these illegal miners use and also arrested and prosecuted both Ghanaians and illegal immigrants engaged in small-scale illegal mining.
We arrested 29 suspects. They were all handed over to the regional headquarters for further investigation. We also had to engage 20 civilians who are swimmers. So there was a need for these local people who could swim in the river to help us, especially with those who are sitting, the chamfaing, which is sitting on the river. River Brim is a very big river, so you need people who can swim to be able to get these people who are illegally mining in the river. And so with the help of those 20 civilians, the operation was successful. We were able to demobilize as many as 226 machines on the river. In some cases, we had to sink them, but we realized that we were kind of polluting the river more. So we decided that we should just demobilize the machines that they were using. And we arrested 20 of them, and then handed them over to the regional headquarters for further investigation.
Galamsey clearly is a corrupted expression of an English phrase that is gather them and sell. So Galamsey, with all natural resources anywhere on earth, the natural resource governance regime requires that anybody wishing or seeking to engage in the exploitation of mineral resources must obtain a license to do so. So a person licensed to do small-scale mining is a licensed small-scale miner. Any other person who has no license to engage in small-scale mining and who is engaging in small-scale mining is doing illegal small-scale mining. For our purposes in Ghana, even a licensed small-scale miner who allows foreign nationals to come onto his concession and engage in small-scale mining activities is committing an offense, and his license can be revoked by reason of the permission of non-Ghanaians to mine gold or minerals on his concession.
Legal small-scale mining is good, especially because it employs a lot of people, generating income and all that. But illegal mining is bad for the simple fact that it's an illegal activity which no country should entertain. Now, I think credit must go to His Excellency the President for being so resolute on this issue. As a country that is a rule of law governed, anything that is illegal must not be entertained. About 34% of this total amount of gold produced in this country came from a combination of small-scale and illegal mining side, which means significant amount of gold is produced through this informal sector. Now, government doesn't get anything out of that. In fact, what government gets from small-scale mining in terms of taxes is very negligible. And our own estimates indicate that government lost about 112 million in taxes that they could have gotten if the amount of gold produced were produced formally. You see, so as a country, we lose. We lose the taxes. We have to find money to rehabilitate the environment which has been destroyed by somebody who got money. You see, the person came, he did Galamsey, got money, but left the negative side there for you and I to go and fail. But you come around and say, oh, we shouldn't do this, we shouldn't do that. Truth is that if they were properly formalized, properly organized, then after production, after getting your money, you pay some taxes to government, you rehabilitate the environment, and you are free.
By holding metropolitan, municipal and district chief executives and district security councils accountable for any illegal mining activity in their areas of jurisdiction, The task force ensures that members of the community are involved in the solution.
This is actually my mining site. This is where I work. Those are excavators. And we have finished mining this place, as you can see. So we are doing reclaiming in Ernest Entries Company. We have, it is a concession of 25 acres. But sometimes some people, the illegal miners sometimes encroach on our lands and trying to put them in order, brings chaos and violence sometimes. When we come and acquire land for mining, the decision on which you mine, there must be an amount of money that you ought to deposit. I suggested 5,000 cedis. If you finish, you reclaim your portion, you go back, take your money. But if you can't, the district use that to reclaim the place. This pit we are seeing here, was dug out by some people, some illegal miners. But because it is very close to our concession, we are doing the reclaiming for it. So it is also a negative impact that it has had on we, the legal miners.
It's like I say, it will be a small-scale mining association. Now, it will be a so. I gain a license or the year a juma. And I guess it will be a Galamsey. It will be a onono, one family acquiring so, and a odd year a juma. A rare omoya Galamsey, omobu do bear 1.8 million, and omoya small scale miners, Ankasanoso, bear 1.2 million. Be a family acquiring so, and yet a jumano. Now, what family acquiring so, a year jumana? Who ye juma police knew so ye be a bar, unsru, ubejinaho, now why a jumano, why in ye?
In spite of these triumphs, a lot more remains to be done. Among other things, a lasting solution has to be found to reverse the pollution of our once pure water bodies.
Don't forget, you are welcome home, welcome home. Come with me on this happy trip back to the ground.
What is the way out? The solution does not lie somewhere in the office of the President of the Republic or in the office of the Minister of State. The solution lies in all of us, every single Ghanaian, recognizing the dangers and the crying need to protect what is left of the beauty of our country. Stakeholders must partner with the government to protect and sustain the modest progress that has been made. In order to bring a decisive end to illegal mining activities in the country. At the end of the day, our fate as a people is tied to the safety of our natural resources. Illegal miners must not be allowed to continue to erode away the beauty and bountiful treasures of our land in the name of short-term and individual benefits.
Ano nti ni Galamsey no mesrɛ na nanom obiɛ ma ne homre so na sɛ ade ne betumi ayeye na ade no entumi enkɔso a efriye nananom if sɛ kuro biɛ ni hɔ a wo hene eni so enti me a me kasa sɛse yɛ sɛ me di kuro bi wo baabi na sɛ me te sɛ Galamsey ekɔso hɔ a ɔni hene ne biem if sɛ na ɔmpo ɔman no eyeye we ayi asɛ de sɛ nananom yɛye.
Hacking away.
Come on back, baby.
digging away. Washing away. Defacing. You've been kept down. Ravishing and stealing. Stand up, please, and say, how long shall they continue to pollute and plunder our water bodies and forests while we stand aside and look? Today, we all need to support the efforts of government, not only because we have to, but because we want to.
My final word to any person wishing to engage in small-scale mining is to take opportunity to engage with the Minerals Commission and the District Assembly, the District Mining Offices, to put in an application for processing. But all of us, as Ghanaians, have a responsibility towards protecting the environment. We have a responsibility to ensure that our people, be they found in villages or in urban centers, live in dignity, because they have a right to a healthy environment. That the indiscriminate and wanton use of mercury and cyanide by illegal small-scale miners compromise our ability to lead a healthy life and will impact negatively on our dignity as persons. And that is why all of us have a responsibility to fight illegal small-scale mining.
Stand up for your country today.